good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here. I'm Beth Sobol. I'm the president of Sobol Fashion Productions, and I'm the founder of Mindy Fashion Week. This year, we're celebrating our 17th year with Mindy Fashion Week. But if you look at this dream, how did it even start? I was actually an international fashion model for 20 years in the 80s and 90s, and I worked in 40 countries as a model.
Woo!
Thank you. When I retired from modeling, I moved home, and some of my model clients found out that it was here. And they asked me to start modeling again. I said, no, I didn't want to model. I had two young children, and I was coming home as a single mother. And this is one of your producer shows. I said, okay, I can do that. After 20 years being on the runway, I had to learn something. But also, when I was a model in Europe, all the other girls smoked. I never smoked. So when they were outside smoking, when we were waiting for the shows to start, I was inside with the lighting guys, the staging guys, the choreographers, the sound guys. And just after all these years, you start learning how the unit operates. So my first clients, when I came back and started my fashion show production company, Russian Chanel, Escada, the St. John, every model, every fashion magazine, everybody I'd ever worked for as a model became my production clients. Within the first few months, I was asked to do an event in Guayaquil, Ecuador. And it was a two-day event for live television. The organizers had 21 designers from 12 Latin American countries. And I spent 15 days with these guys. They all wanted to come back to Miami. Nobody knew how. So 2 years later, I lost the first Miami Fashion Week in Guatemala. We did the first event in 1999. My first special guest designer was Tony Herrera. The national star in fashion that year was Aniel Sanchez. My next year, my guest was Oscar De La Renta. And it goes on and on. And now we've grown so much. We've been here for a few years in Woodland. We've been at Miami Beach for the last 7 years. I've taken an apartment to the event. And now we are live streaming to 600,000 people per show. It's not just the 700 in the audience anymore. It's hundreds of thousands of people who are watching our shows now. So this is the growth of the event that we've taken to, and we're very much moving to the digital world as well. It's not really going to reach everyone. And last year we had about 70 designers in 25 countries with us. And we are actually reorganizing, and we'll be doing the next event in 2016. So everybody who's been asking me, when's the show, it's next year. And next week, I'll be able to announce a lot of really wonderful things that are going on. We had some meetings last night. I'm not privy to divulge what these meetings were tonight. I wish I could because it is so exciting. But next Tuesday, and all the press are here, check your inboxes, because next Tuesday you're going to have the information. And then we're going on from there, and I will be continuing to develop my two nonprofits like that, which are the Council of International Fashion Designers, and also the Council of International Fashion Designers Foundation. And these are the organizations that we have, you know, mentoring programs and scholarships. We have competitions with students and emerging designers. Just a lot of different opportunities for continuing education and further development of designers. Most of the designers that we've worked with all this time have been from other countries. 95% of the designers come from another country. They want to enter the U.S. market. So this is what we do. And I learned early on that most of the designers from Latin America, these other countries, were stars in their own countries. But they didn't know how to do business in this country. So that's where all the master classes and the education components have been developed. And that's what I'm going to continue on, developing things further for all the next generation of the designers coming on.
We'll interview each person, we'll introduce themselves, and we'll ask them a few questions, and we'll circle back and we'll allow you to ask some questions. So I'm going a little off the paper. We had a few questions, but for you, Beth, I personally would like to know, because I didn't know you started out as a model. So of course you're seeing your beauty, and you know, was it challenging for you to for people to take you seriously from them knowing you as a model to now you're a businesswoman? Did you face any challenges, and what was the biggest obstacle that you had to deal with? Getting people to take you seriously as a woman, but not just a woman, but a very beautiful woman.
Let me tell you, I was the most serious runway model there ever was. This was my business. This is how I earned my living. Like I said, those other girls not smoking, I wasn't. I was learning the business. I was meeting the clients. I was making more friends. And every time that I was in Europe, I would go to a different country. I lived in Paris for many years, and you work in 3 or 4 countries in a week. It's very easy to do over there. But every country I went to, I sent a postcard back to my clients here. So in a week, they get a card from Paris, the one from Germany, one from Milan, one from here, one from there. So they could track my movements. Back then, we didn't have cell phones. We didn't have computers. I walked around with a handful of quarters, dimes, for telephone machines. In Europe, you had to go to the post office and place a call. So that was my way of staying in touch with everybody. And as far as like business sense, modeling was my business. That's why I earned my living. And I permeated that into my business that I have now. But I will say one thing, I'll add one thing into this, that the year before I started modeling full-time, I had a job as a legal secretary trainee. Couldn't even tell. I don't know why I got this job, but I did. But it was the best thing I ever did, because that year I learned how to read contracts. I learned how to type a little better too.
I'm sure that you've received lots of advice, and of course, you know, 20 years of experience in business, or 20 plus years, but what is one of the best pieces of advice you've ever received in one sentence? It doesn't have to be one. I mean, the best advice that you have received, just, I would say, in your transition from, even though modeling is entrepreneurship for sure, because you are your business, but transferring from being a model to launching this huge international brand that you have now.
I don't know that I ever received, you know, advice from somebody else, honestly, because I put my head down and I go. Nobody's stopping me. Nobody's in my way. If I got something in my mind, I'm going to get down, and I will do it. I'll find a way to do it. I'll jump into a podcast and jump. I will get there. And with you, you here in the audience back there who might know me, I think you can attest to that. It's a lot of hard work. It's a lot of dedication. And nobody can tell me no, because I will find someone saying yes. So for me, it was never give up. But if you believe in it, and the first year I did fashion, the first year in 1999, I knew I had something. And even though it could be tough, trying to get sponsors, trying to get the money, trying to get the support, trying to get the venue, all this stuff, because even kept growing, it got bigger and bigger and bigger. I always knew I had something, and that's why I never gave up. And every year we've had a fashion year.
What do you think of the event?
I thought it was a great event tonight. It's my first time coming. I think all of you young guys are doing a terrific job, and you've got your whole underground network of these young entrepreneurs coming into the industry, and I really applaud you for the work you're doing with this, bringing everyone together.
Well, we thank you very much for coming. And what do you foresee in the future in fashion and entrepreneurship?
They go hand in hand. The future in fashion is ever-changing. It changes every 3 months, so that's up to the designers. But the entrepreneurship and the young designers coming out, the young creative talent, just make it your own. Don't look back. Look to the future. That's where fashion is going, to the future.
That's an interesting fact, that the fashion changes every 3 months. So thank you very much, Ms. Sobol, for coming again. And, well, give us a shout-out to South Florida entrepreneurs.
Great job, South Florida entrepreneurs.